Close enough. What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Justin, and today we're listening to the band Klaatu with their song Calling Occupants of Interplanetary Craft. This is off of their debut album, 347 EST. This is a recommendation, kind of, by Christopher Tisdale, who had private messaged me on Twitter. So thank you, Chris. I appreciate the recommendation. Chris said that I would enjoy any song on this album. He specifically had mentioned the last song on this one, Little Neutrino. But, especially because he said I'd enjoy anything on the album, I decided to just start from the beginning, as I've been trying to do every once in a while. I figured the first song on their debut album would be like the best place to start in listening to them. And apparently they were confused as the Beatles, who they thought like this band was the Beatles, like secretly reuniting, which is really interesting. You know that feeling when you're about to sneeze, but you don't sneeze, you just feel like it's there? I have that right now, and I hate it. You guys can join me on Twitter, you guys can join me in the comments down below. I hope that you're having a fantastic day, and let's get into it. This is Calling Occupants of Interplanetary Craft, I love the title, by Klaatu. Or is it Klaatu? Klaatu or Klaatu? I don't know. Let's just do this one.
Capacities, you know, to telepath messages through the vast unknown. Please close your eyes and concentrate with every thought you think upon the recitation we're about to sing. Of interplanetary craft, calling occupants of interplanetary most extraordinary craft. Yeah. transmit thought energy far beyond the norm. You close your eyes, you concentrate, together that's the way to send the message. We declare world contact.
Gotta admit, I haven't listened to a lot of the Beatles, but I can definitely tell, like, from the very beginning of this song, it definitely had a very strong Beatles sound to it. I could definitely understand that part. What I thought was most interesting throughout the song was the dynamics and interplay between the synths and the keyboard, because sometimes the passages were going on together at the same time, and it sounded just really cool because you had the spaciness and the sci-fi-ness of the synths playing, but then at the same time you would have the piano in the background playing along, providing very nice lines. Really like the hypnotic and dreaminess of the vocals. They're very smooth, just very like relaxed, very laid back, like I said. Just had a nice vibe to them. Before I talk about the song anymore, because I know I'm going to forget, I have to talk about, there's a certain point, and there's a few times actually, there's certain melodies in there that, I mean, tell me if I'm wrong on this one, but it sounds a bit like Phantom of the Opera, right? Like, hold on. Right there, come on. That's Phantom of the Opera. I'm just saying, I don't know about that one. Whose real name was Eric. Didn't know that, did you? I felt like this song was just this, like, really nice dream. It just had that kind of sound going for it, really. Whether it was the singing, whether it was those spacey synths. And what I like about that is that for a song that's called Calling Occupants of Interplanetary Craft, it didn't feel so out there, right? It didn't feel so sci-fi, like it was unattainable or it was just too far off. Not that that's necessarily a bad thing, but I like how they brought it down. They put the perfect amount of that kind of tone into the song. Through the keyboard work. Like, this does sound pretty Beatles-esque, right? Like, but I think that they make it their own. They do have that kind of similar style. It's still drenched in that same progressive, psychedelic kind of sound, absolutely. But I think that they make it their own, and I think that they do some interesting things with it. Such as the momentum that they keep throughout the song, especially with the drum fills, very powerful and big moments. Yeah. There's a great sense of melody with this song. A great sense of the harmonies that come in, not only vocally, but between the instruments and the music itself. And even going through the vocoder here on the vocals with a more powerful drum, it gets a little harsh before it lightens itself up again. Like, they have a great structure in this song. It's 7 minutes. Doesn't feel like 7 minutes to me. They do a great job of experimenting with their sound while still maintaining a nice foundation, something for especially first-time listeners like myself to grab onto musically. And the playfulness of some of the lyricism is really nicely done as well. I like that little run-on sentence that goes on in the chorus, and of course that's repeated throughout the song. But I like how it's just like a fun little run-through to like kind of break up the lines of the chorus. And that's what I kind of get from this song. It's very easygoing, it's fun, there's still a little bit of progression and a little bit of experimentation in there, but not too much. Now, where they go further, I couldn't tell you, unless we keep going. And this is such a fun jam moment with the piano, especially. Listen to the bass providing that bounce. That's good, that's good. This is a really good song, and I'm definitely curious about more from the band. So first of all, the album is named 347 because of the movie The Day the Earth Stood Still, in which the alien emissary, Klaatu, arrives in Washington, D.C. at 347 in the afternoon. Speaking of which, what were you guys doing at 3:47 today? At the time of you watching this video, especially if it's 3:47, what were you doing? I was at work counting down the minutes. This song was covered by the Carpenters? Was it? Like Karen and Richard Carpenter?
Hear it. We are station we're about to stay.
Maybe I'll listen to that on my own. I don't know. That, I love her voice, absolutely. So to hear her do that song, I have to revisit that at some point. On camera or on my own, not sure yet. The lyrics. I almost read out intro forest noises. Yes, yes there were. But I do like how they set up this journey by, you know, literally the sound of someone walking through the woods, the grass and leaves crunching beneath their feet before they pause and come to a stop, and then the music begins at that point. In which case, the verse begins, "In your mind you have capacities, you know, to telepath messages through the vast unknown. Please close your eyes and concentrate with every thought you think upon the recitation we're about to sing." They lead into the chorus, "Calling occupants of interplanetary craft, calling occupants of interplanetary craft, most extraordinary craft." While it seems that this isn't necessarily literally like an alien spaceship or a UFO kind of craft, this is more just like such strong mind signals, like just sending, I guess, like good vibes and like mental vibes to each other. Like, this interplanetary craft is your mind. "You've been observing our Earth, and we'd like to make a contact with you. We are your friends." Okay, it could be aliens too. "Please come in peace, we beseech you. Only a landing will teach them. Our Earth may never survive, so do come, we beg you. Please, interstellar policeman, won't you give us a sign? Give us a sign that we've reached you." Okay. So, maybe it's a little more than just the mental. It could be a total Independence Day thing here. Send Will Smith out there to welcome them to Earth. This was a good song. I'm curious about this cover. By Carpenters. I'm not particularly aware of that. I don't know. Anyways, you guys are more than welcome to join me on Twitter. You can join me in the comments down below. I hope that you're having a wonderful day. I hope that you're having a fantastic day. I hope that you're having an interstellar day. And I'll talk to you guys later.